Hello, and welcome to Daily Prayer for Wednesday, the 26th of May. As we start, we remember our wonderful Father in heaven. We say together, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. So let us obey and be still and know that God is God. Perhaps take a moment to breathe in deeply and imagine God filling you afresh with his Spirit. And breathe out hassles, stresses, or worries, remembering that God can take care of all of them. He is our good shepherd. We pray for God's kingdom to come. Look back at the last 24 hours and give thanks for things that have been good. I'm feeling grateful for on my day off on Monday, having a good bike ride and the weather that staying okay, the joys of cafes opening, the delight of a nice large flapjack. Delighted at my garden and the flowers coming out, particularly a lot of purple alliums. Delight on Tuesday to be able to meet with friends and colleagues in a core group I'm part of, for us to be able to pray for one another while still not touching. Thankful for the small youth group. The older part of Chatterbox at St John's and the Zoom course I took part with them tonight. Pray for God's healing and God's way forward for things that have made you sad. I'd value prayer for a couple of individuals who've fallen out, for someone I know struggling with concerns for her family. For those on our hearts this day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So, Father, we do pray for an end to the coronavirus, for protection in this country, particularly where the so-called Indian variant is making numbers rise so dramatically. Far more, Father, we pray for India. For other countries that don't have our resources, we pray for your help for them, for governments, for charities to play their part. And Father, we give you thanks for the ceasefire, truce in Israel and the Palestinian territories. Father, we cry out to you for rebuilding, for lasting peace and healing for so many who are bereaved. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our own churches, as we move from responding to the crisis to recovery, to starting again, where many are mourning, where many are tired and exhausted, where many are still nervous, where we're in different points. Pray for that process, for wisdom, for sensitivity, as we move towards reconstructing, perhaps doing things differently. Father, may we have your wisdom. May we have your way. And we pray that you'll take all the imperfects that we can give and bring your healing, your light, your good news. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. To consider the day ahead of you, what you're looking forward to, perhaps what worries you. I'd love your prayers for an assembly I'm taking at St Andrews tomorrow morning, but doing it via the computer, which I don't like because I can't just ask the children questions and get them to do my assembly for me. For well, hopefully a meeting with a friend and a couple of hours off tomorrow afternoon. And for you may have heard Sue Harvey is retiring from working in the parish office for me to get on top of plans for recruiting a new administrator to work with Joan. And to give so much wonderful help. For whatever lies before you this day, let us offer to God what we can and trust Him to provide what we need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light upon our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all people in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Continuing to read from 2 Corinthians. Perhaps getting now to the major theme of the letter. Paul has started with greetings and his prayers for the Corinthians, for pointing them to God and the God of wonderful comfort. Now he writes, now this is our boast. Our conscience testifies that we have conducted ourselves in the world, and especially in our relations with you, with integrity and godly sincerity. We have done so, relying not on worldly wisdom, but on God's grace. For we do not write to you anything you cannot read or understand. And I hope that, as you have understood us in part, you will come to understand fully that you can boast of us just as we will boast of you in the day of the Lord Jesus. Because I was confident of this, I wanted to visit you first so that you might benefit twice. I wanted to visit you on my way to Macedonia and to come back to you from Macedonia, and then to let you send me on my way to Judea. Was I fickle when I intended to do this? Or do I make my plans in a worldly manner? So that in the same breath I say, yes, and no. But as surely as God is faithful, our message to you is not yes and no. For the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who was preached among you by us, by me, Silas, and Timothy, was not yes and no, but in him it has always been yes. For no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ. And so through him, the Amen is spoken by us to the glory of God. Now it is God who makes both us and you stand firm in Christ. He anointed us, set his seal of ownership on us, and put his spirit in our hearts as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. I call God as my witness, and I stake my life on it, that it was in order to spare you that I did not return to Corinth. Not that we lord it over your faith, but we work with you for your joy, because it is by faith you stand firm. So I made up my mind that I would not make another painful visit to you. For I grieve you. Who is left to make me glad but you whom I have grieved? I wrote as I did, so that when I came, I would not be distressed by those who should have made me rejoice. I have confidence in all of you, that you would all share my joy. For I wrote to you out of great distress and anguish of heart, and with many tears, not to grieve you, but to let you know the depth of my love for you. To try to understand this letter, we can to some extent only speculate. It appears that Paul wrote three letters to the Corinthians. The first one that we looked at earlier in the year, 1 Corinthians in our Bibles, a second letter that is probably lost, and now this third letter. And the second letter appears to be a significant rebuke to the Corinthians. Some have suggested that there may have been editing by the early church, and some of that letter might have been incorporated into 1 Corinthians. And some words in 1 Corinthians are really quite critical of the church in Corinth, the way they take their communion services, and so on. We don't know. But what we do know is that Paul wrote some critical words to the church in Corinth out of his love and his concern for them. And so he didn't visit them at the same time, but gave them time maybe to respond, hopefully to repent, as perhaps the easiest way of bringing healing. We don't know. We'll discover more of the tensions as the letter progresses. But let's just pause and think about that command that God has always given us, that we should love one another, especially our enemies. That if we have a gift to put on the altar but find we've got something against our brother, we should do our very best to be reconciled to our brother or our sister. May that love be always at the heart of what we do. And may we pray for the church, for individuals where they're divided. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And of course, we can be part of the causes of division. We're not perfect. So forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Christ, light of the world, scatter our darkness. Let your healing spring up with the dawn. In the darkness around us, let us, as your church, be a still place of light, a still place of love, a still place of peace, a still place of your presence. Through us, let your light shine, Let your love enfold. Let your peace fill. Let your presence be known. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. So may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and the love of God, of his Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, rest upon you and remain with you, this day and always. Amen. Thank you for playing with me, perhaps for me. I hope you have a good day. Bye-bye.